Jim Clark, good morning from Marietta, Georgia. Would you please explain the importance of remnant cholesterol values? Longer in blood system is bad, so the lower the better. I simplified it, but is that acceptable? That's correct. Dave Feldman has a good section on remnant cholesterol. There are a couple of other places where if you look up remnant cholesterol, and actually I talked about it in, I think, one of my most recent blogs. I've also got a couple of videos on remnant cholesterol. Here's what it is. It's VLDL and IDL. Now, that doesn't help very much, does it? But let's think back through it and you understand what it is. VLDL is very low density lipoprotein. IDL is intermediate density lipoprotein. In fact, I'm going to go back and share. I think I have an image that will show this. So these are VLDL, very low density lipoproteins. IDL is intermediate density lipoproteins. Then LDL and HDL. Now you see the VLDL are by far the biggest. The IDL are also big. Now, as you mentioned, these don't last in the bloodstream very long. They are very triglyceride laden particles, tend to come from the gut where triglyceride is being absorbed from a meal. So the body works very quickly to try to get those VLDL numbers down and the IDL numbers down. Now, if your triglycerides are really high, and if you have problems with your lipid and insulin metabolism, you don't have as many places to put the triglycerides. As we mentioned before, your insulin resistance is cranking up. It's stimulating your lipase, your hormone-sensitive lipase, and you're getting too much activity, too much push of fatty acids into this transport system. Once you decrease your carbs, you don't get all of those fatty acids being pushed in. And so then you have these large fluffy HDLs and large fluffy LDLs that the cholesterol ester can use to transfer, and other mechanisms can use to transfer that triglyceride out of your system. So again, hope I didn't butcher that explanation too much. Bottom line is, yeah, you want to get those triglyceride laden particles, the VLDL and IDL, out of the system. Now, wait a minute. We thought we were talking about remnant cholesterol. Why did you go to VLDL and IDL? VLDL and IDL are remnant cholesterol. How do you calculate it? Well, you take your HDL and your LDL, you add those together, and you subtract that from your total cholesterol. And the goal numbers, the lower you get, the better. And again, below, most people will say, below 20 is a good number. And yes, you'll see people with up in the 40s and 50s, and that's not a good remnant cholesterol number to have. Thank you so much, Jim. Great question. Gave me a great opportunity for another bunny trail. Why wait for a disease and hope for a cure? I used to be an ER doc. My name is Ford Brewer. I quit ER after a few years because it was just so frustrating. Most of the things bringing people into the ER are things that should have been prevented, including heart attack, stroke, number one cause of death, number one cause of permanent disability. People think that you're just going to have those and that they're not predictable. Both of those are wrong. They are predictable and you don't have to have them. Usually it's lifestyle. Lifestyle is more important than supplements and even prescription drugs and even stents and surgery. But the current times are tough. Major financial impact with the lockdowns that most states have been going through. We've been working on a way to make this much more affordable with a subscription process. And that's exactly what we're announcing today. We've got two levels. One is the Silver membership, where you get access to our courses, a private webinar each month, and access to our supplement store and supplement recommendations and prescription. Or I would suggest even more so, the Gold membership. You can get a script for a freestyle Libre and find out what your blood sugar metabolism's doing on a daily basis. And you can get a lab order for inflammation, OGTT, and insulin survey. You can also get a 30-minute one-on-one with me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you. Cost is no longer an excuse. So if you're interested, go to go.prevmedheartrest.com/prevmed-subscription or call us at 859-721-1414, 859-721-1414, or email us at myhealth@prevmedheartrest.com. Looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.